Given recent legal updates, it is now clear that compliance in terms of digital accessibility comes down to conformance with the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, version 2.1, conformance level AA. On the screen with me is a post from accessible.org titled WCAG 2.1 AA Training for Compliance. And we're going to go through a few sections of this post so I can answer some common questions that will come up. First, is WCAG hard to learn? No. Even though the official documentation for the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines is difficult to understand and it's extremely long, WCAG 2.1 AA comes down to 50 success criteria. So think of these as things to do or requirements for conformance. And when we look at the plain English explanations of these requirements, it's not that difficult to understand. So another question is, what's the best way to learn WCAG 2.1 AA? Well, you need beginner-friendly training that is in plain English, and you want to have as many different ways to learn about the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines as possible. So video explanations, text explanations, illustrations, code examples, and this is going to help you absorb the material better. You know, there's going to be a slight learning curve if you are new to accessibility, but when everything is broken down and you're just looking at each success criterion and you're focused on one success criterion at a time, it's going to be much, much easier to learn. So to answer the question, what's the best way to learn about WCAG? Well, in the way that suits you, and just making sure that there are different ways to absorb the material. And again, the WCAG course is going to have these different ways of absorbing the material. How fast can you learn WCAG 2.1 AA? Well, the WCAG course takes about 3 hours to get through. And this means you would be able to understand the basics for all of the success criteria. But proficiency is going to take at least a few weeks. So it's a matter of repetition and putting the requirements into practice. And ultimately, you just need experience with the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, but it won't take too long and you'll instantly get a good feel for the requirements. And then it's just a matter of working through them, remembering them, and then adding to the essentials. So the core requirement of the success criterion, and then building upon that with any additional details that are relevant or any exceptions to the success criterion. But you know, one other part of this is when we're learning about the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, we're just learning the requirements that comprise WCAG 2.1 AA. It's not, you know, we're not even putting it into practice at this time, but as you start to work through the different success criteria, you'll learn them even better. Can I learn success criteria for a specific role? Absolutely, and this is actually recommended. So for example, if you're a content editor, then you should focus in on the success criteria that relate to content. So the success criteria that relate to text, images, video, and audio. There's already enough to unpack here, and if your role doesn't go beyond that, then the other success criteria, while still important, are not really relevant to you in your daily activities. So if you focus in on these for what is applicable for you and your role, then you can just focus in on certain success criteria and then go beyond those success criteria when you would like to, if you would like to. And one nice thing about the WCAG course is I divide and organize all of the success criteria by your different roles. So by content editor, by designer, and by developer, so that everyone knows which success criteria are relevant to them. Can non-technical people learn the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines? Absolutely. So even if you're non-technical, you're new to accessibility, you don't understand how to code, you can still easily learn the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines as long as you're going through good training. And one of the best ways to think about WCAG is you're only learning about what's necessary for conformance. You don't actually have to put it into practice yet. So you're just learning what these different success criteria are requiring. So even though they may require things that are more technically advanced in application, you don't have to worry about the advanced technical aspects because you're only learning what is required of the different success criteria. Is there a checklist I can start with? Yes, absolutely. And I will link to that below. It's the accessible.org checklist. And there is also a guide that can help you learning and picking up and becoming more familiar with the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. And I will link to those below. What WCAG 2.1 AA training tips will help the most? So understanding the context of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines will help prepare you and set you up for learning the actual success criteria because it will give you context. And also know that WCAG is fairly easy. So you might have this idea that this is very hard and difficult, but actually once you break down the official documentation, so you break down the technical terms and the jargon and the more ambiguous wording, you break that down into easier to understand plain language, it's really not too bad. Also, I recommend that you start by studying each success criterion by itself and not trying to combine everything together. So when you run through a checklist, it might seem like, oh, okay, this is really easy, and you're just reading through one success criterion after another. But it's good to just isolate each success criterion and learn that and for the moment, master it by itself before continuing on to the next. As you're going through the different success criteria, think about what they mean in practice and how they help with accessibility, because this will enhance your context and give you a better understanding of the requirement if you think of the requirement beyond just trying to remember what it requires. So in a way, this is analogous to rather than just trying to memorize the information that is on the test or might be asked on the test, try to memorize or try to think how this actually works in real life, because the practical application will help you better remember what's required. Also, I recommend studying at your own pace. If you have a companion checklist to review after you go through each lesson, that's going to help reinforce the information. And then at first, I wouldn't worry too much about the exceptions and the extended details. Some of the success criterion are fairly, basic in their requirement, but then once you look at the details, it adds more layers. So at first, I would just focus in on having the key takeaways for each success criterion and then going and building upon that. So once you have the key idea, the basic premise behind each success criterion, then go into the more advanced aspects, the more details, the more layers behind the success criteria. And then so the last part I have in this post is what is the WCAG course? So this is my course. It is designed to be beginner friendly and help anybody learn the web content accessibility guidelines. The course contains video and text explanations, plain English explanations. There are also additional resources if you need help learning the success criteria, but also putting the success criteria into practice. So it's just different ways to think about it. And then also these resources really help you in the practical application of the success criteria. Everything is organized by module, so you can learn WCAG 2.0 first, then 2.1, then 2.2 is also in the course if you want to learn it. If you don't, it's there. You won't have to worry about that module. And then there are also multiple resources inside the course. So there is an Excel spreadsheet checklist with all of the different versions of WCAG separated and then combined together. And then there is a WCAG in chunks cheat sheet to help you think of a way to combine the different success criteria when they're related. And there are also accessibility workflows documents to help you understand the success criteria that are involved in the different workflows for the different roles. So this course really has everything to help you absorb and implement WCAG into your processes and help you work through the different success criteria. So this course is going to be extremely helpful. I will include a link to the WCAG course, but for now, just understand that the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, while you may think they are difficult and initially they may seem difficult, they're not too bad as long as you just break everything down into chunks and you have it explained in a way that makes sense. When you look through the official documentation, it is very technical. At times it is ambiguous, but when you extract the meaning that the documentation is getting at, it's really not that bad. So I will include links to all of the resources I've discussed in this video in the description.